Trial and error is part of success, even if it involves rockets exploding in the sky. Starship gave us quite a show. During today's first flight test of a fully integrated Starship and Super Heavy rocket, from Starbase in Texas. SpaceX captured nationwide attention Thursday morning, as its massive Starship rocket lifted off from southern Texas, and combusted just minutes later over the Gulf of Mexico. But what could be deemed a fiery failure actually provides crucial insights into a landmark rocket that is key to NASA's plan to return to the moon and possibly beyond, according to aerospace experts. At 8:33 a.m., Starship successfully lifted off from the orbital launch pad for the first time. The vehicle cleared the pad, and beaches Starship climbed to an apogee of approximately 39 in, over the Gulf of Mexico, the highest of any Starship to date. The vehicle experienced multiple engines out during the flight test, lost altitude, and began to tumble. From a nearby vantage point, the rocket rumbled and the smoke billowed outward, but it seemed like an eternity before Starship poked its head above the smoke and dust. And then it climbed skyward, a brilliant silvery and fiery streak in the sky. What could not be immediately discerned from the ground is that a handful of the Super Heavy first stage's 33 Raptor engines failed in the early moments of the flight. After about 2 minutes, more engines failed. Before the end, when the rocket reached a peak altitude just short of 40 kilometers, as many as 8 engines appeared to have gone out. Understandably, this appears to have led to some control issues at around the moment when the Starship upper stage was supposed to separate from the first stage of the rocket. It's also possible that a hydraulics problem contributed to an inability to control the direction of the remaining engine's thrust. The flight termination system was commanded on both the booster and ship. As is standard procedure, the pad and surrounding area was cleared, well in advance of the test, and we expect the road and beach near the pad to remain closed until tomorrow. With a test like this, success comes from what we learn, and we learned a tremendous amount about the vehicle and ground systems today that will help us improve on future flights of Starship. For a general audience who sees NASA at work, an agency that can't afford to fail, this looks like failure. NASA failures often involve the loss of human life or billion-dollar satellites. So yeah, government explosions are bad. But this was not that. For those who know a bit more about the launch industry and the iterative design methodology, getting the Super Heavy rocket and Starship upper stage off the launch pad was a huge success. Why? Because one could sit in meetings for ages and discuss everything that could go wrong with a rocket like this, with an unprecedented number of first stage engines and its colossal size. The alternative is simply to get the rocket into a good enough configuration and go fly. Flying is the ultimate test, providing the best data. There is no more worrying about theoretical failures. The company's engineers actually get to identify what is wrong and then go and fix it. But you have to accept some failure. So SpaceX's process is messier, but it is also much faster. NASA spent billions of dollars, and the better part of a decade constructing the Space Launch System rocket, that had a nearly flawless debut flight, aside from damage to the launch tower, in late 2022. NASA followed a linear design method, complete with extensive and expensive analysis, because a failure of the SLS rocket would have raised serious questions about the agency's competence. Fortunately for SpaceX, the company can afford to fail. It can do so because it has already built 3 more Super Heavy rockets that are nearly ready to fly. In fact, SpaceX can build 10 Super Heavy first stages in the time it takes NASA to build a single SLS rocket. If the first 5 fail but the next 5 succeed, which is a better outcome? How about in 2 or 3 years, when SpaceX is launching and landing a dozen or more Super Heavy rockets, while NASA's method allows it a single launch a year? So, yes, SpaceX's rocket exploded on Thursday. The company will learn, and it will fly again, perhaps sometime later this fall or winter. Soon, it probably will be flying frequently. Engineers will tell you that they can learn as much from failure as a success, said Margaret Whitecamp, the chair of the Space History Department at the National Air and Space Museum in Washington. There's always something to be learned from any sort of test. The point at which the failure happens tells them something about what was working up to that point and where things went wrong. Praise poured in from rocket watchers and space experts tuned into the launch. Bill Nelson, NASA administrator, congratulated SpaceX and tweeted that, Every great achievement throughout history has demanded some level of calculated risk, because with great risk comes great reward. French astronaut Thomas Pesquet tweeted, "Never mistake trial for failure." How SpaceX succeeded here. Starship lifted off from SpaceX's launch facility in Boca Chica, Texas, just after 9:30 a.m. Eastern Time Thursday morning. About 4 minutes into its flight time, and 24 miles in the air, the unmanned rocket tumbled, spun out of control and exploded over the Gulf of Mexico. The sheer scale of Starship, which is deemed the world's most powerful rocket, and its successful liftoff is a feat in itself. This is a very large launch vehicle, and bigger can be more complicated to engineer, Whitecamp said. It's very impressive. The problems began as SpaceX attempted main engine cutoff and separation. This is a key window for SpaceX engineers. It provides insight into what was working well in the spacecraft, and what wasn't, and will inform engineers how to ready its future spacecraft for launch. It is too soon to speculate what happened there, Whitecamp said. Engineers learn a lot from failure, and that's a part of the engineering process. And having a failure at that point still meant that this was a flight that had a number of things go really right. The field of space exploration is filled with launches, tests and experiments gone awry. Whitecamp recalled hearing Simon Ramo, an aerospace engineer, speak at a conference in Washington in the 1990s. He happily described an early launch of his that took off, but quickly went sideways, leaving no option but for a range officer to destroy it. He was very pleased, Whitecamp said. Ramo pointed out that there was great success in his sideways launch, major parts of the rocket clearly worked. The actual propulsion was working, we now just need to make it go up, Whitecamp recalled him saying. One can always learn from things that literally go sideways. SpaceX's track record blasting off and blowing up. Falcon 9, the company's partially reusable launch vehicle, blew up twice, once during a launch of cargo to the International Space Station in 2015, and another time during an engine test while it was on the launchpad a year later. But SpaceX also lost several Falcon 9 rockets to explosions, when the company was still trying to nail landing the system. Today, it may be the most reliable rocket in history, with 61 successful launches last year. Space exploration won't be hampered, following the Starship combustion Thursday morning, or rapid and scheduled disassembly, as SpaceX described it. Elon Musk said, in a few months, the company will simply try again. Thank you to our customers, Cameron County, and the wider community for the continued support and encouragement. And congratulations to the entire SpaceX team on an exciting first flight test of Starship.